Semana passada eu tive a oportunidade de conversar com o Ficra, um irlandês, uma pessoa muito especial que abraçou uma causa aqui em prol aos estudantes internacionais, principalmente os brasileiros. Para quem não sabe, muita gente passou ou está passando dificuldade aqui na Irlanda por conta da pandemia, né? Brasileiros foram ameaçados, né, de ser despejados, até ameaçados de morte por conta de não conseguir dinheiro para pagar o aluguel. Teve uma matéria bem sensacionalista de um jornal, até de cunho racista, né, alegando que 99% dos estudantes que estariam embora da Irlanda eram brasileiros que estariam se aproveitando do benefício do governo por conta da pandemia, enfim. Felizmente nós temos pessoas aí que olham sim por esses estudantes, tá? O Ficra montou uma associação para ajudar esses estudantes e ele fala um pouquinho nesse vídeo. Na verdade eu separei por dois vídeos, né? No final desse primeiro vídeo eu deixo o link do outro para vocês continuarem, tá? É curtinho, acho que vale a pena assistir, até mesmo porque muitas pessoas têm me perguntado se por conta dessa matéria os irlandeses iam ter algum tipo de preconceito com os brasileiros, se ia ter alguma dificuldade, se o governo iria vetar a entrada de futuros intercambistas e por aí vai, tá bom? Acho importante que vocês assistam. Vamos lá. I was very happy to hear from you when you, in a reply to a tendentious post from an Irish website, which was trying to make people believe that students were taking advantage, taking money from the government benefits to leave Ireland to their own countries, and that 99% of those students were Brazilians. Do you want to talk a little bit about this situation?
That particular case you're talking about was one journalist, a case of very irresponsible journalism. So the students who I've been dealing with were being attacked by this one journalist, and whether they had said Brazilian or, you know, whether they said Mexican, you can never allow people to attack a whole reputation of a whole people, you know, without knowing the facts. Also, you know, I'm a friend of Brazil. I've lived there and I really enjoy how Brazilians are so inclusive. There's so much I celebrate, my friendships, music, the art, everything. So I think as well, it's just we have to not let that lazy journalism and lazy language inform people, because we're in a crisis and people don't know what to believe. So when I saw, you know, people as a journalist saying, insulting my Brazilian friends, it just made me sad, you know, and I thought, wow, because I know how that could affect. They go, oh, how do the Irish feel about us? And the thing is, we love you. We love your culture. We love how you are. So a forma de ser, no? Su sentido de brincadeira, de, sí. And how heartfelt your connections are, you know? And, you know, in class every day, the students, they tell me about their saudade for their family and, you know, and missing and that. And I mean, you know, so we got to make sure we protect this very valuable connection that we have between our peoples. Mm-hmm. You know, Brazil is happy, the world is happy, is a happier place. And when Brazil is sad, the world is a sadder place. And I know there's significant challenges in Brazil right now, you know, with not just the medical emergency, but in society, this conversation's happening. I always know, because I have such respect, that Brazilians will find their way forward, and that you're in a moment of crisis, but we will not allow anyone to attack the reputation of Brazil when this is happening. So that's all I would say. We have to be there for each other and supporting each other. And the students have been great ambassadors for your people, for your country, and I'm just so happy that so many of them are my friends as well as students, you know.
Nice. Well, it's very nice to hear that from you. Thank you very much about, you know, everything you have done for the Brazilian community here in Ireland. Hope these things pass away soon.
I think things will be very interesting, and we're doing really good work together, and that's the most important thing. And I just want to say similarly, I really appreciate everyone who's made the effort to come over here and to become part of our society. It's really exciting, and it makes Ireland more of a home for me when I can see these cultures and the people and the learning that's happening here. It's a really exciting time to be alive. And despite the medical crisis, Ireland has become such a wonderful place in recent years. And a lot of that is down to the people who've come and made it special.
Yeah, yeah. I love Irish culture as well. I actually think that the Irish culture is more similar to Brazilian culture, you know, the humor, sense of humor. Yeah, for example, when I go here in UK, the British people are very, you know, polite, but it's different. Mm-hmm. You know, the Irish people are always like, hey man, how, if you go to the pub, you can count like 5 minutes and some Irish guy will come to you and, hey, where are you from? Oh, nice weather. Let's get a pint. And
yeah,
it's very nice. It's very similar than our, you know, environment.
Oh, absolutely. You know, Brazilians are so inclusive. And for being such a big country, such a population, such a size, it's incredible because, you know, you do have that sense of togetherness and welcoming.